With me here today from Faron Pharmaceuticals, I'm joined by Markku Jalkanen. Markku, good to catch up. Good morning.
Thank you.
You've had an update on the MATIN study out recently, making some really good progress here. Just give us an update of where you're at the moment.
It's really progressing well and pretty much as we planned. We have now reached the maximum dosing level what we are aiming for, and that's 10 micrograms per kilo. It continues to be well tolerated, and we have observed a significant immunoactivation changes in those patients. And of course, we are really looking forward now, really following the patients, how they actually are responding to the treatment.
How many patients have been dosed?
9 so far.
Right. And is that how many are you looking to dose?
Well, this is the dose escalation part, and then we do some rechecking with the dosings. And once we have optimized the dosing, then we can really go and move on into the cohort escalation. And as we have indicated previously, our first target group will be the colorectal cancer, where we have had now first partial responder, meaning that the tumor sizes are shrinking within the person. And then also we have one biochemical responder observed. So it looks really promising by that matter.
So are you, so far, is this exceeding expectations?
Yeah, I mean, normally you have a dose escalation which is really looking for safety, because obviously this is the trial first in man, and you have to make sure that you don't have any serious complications. And so far, we think that we have been avoided those. So now that it's really moving towards really looking at the efficacy of the treatment itself once everything is optimized. And this fall will be really exciting for us, because then we start to get more patients. The start is usually a bit slow because you have to wait the safety period. So you can't do anything. You just wait and see if anything happens. But now when that is passed, then we move on and start to recruit patients more frequently.
And when will that be?
It's the third quarter of this year.
Right.
So pretty soon.
Just remind us, just taking a step back for people perhaps hearing about this for the first time, just right. What is the overall objective? What are you looking at?
We are looking at of removal immune suppressive elements which the tumor has attracted around them, and that immune suppression prevents the host immune system to recognize the tumor as a foreign material and forget to kind of attack it. And that's the reason why tumor grows. And with our antibody treatment against a Clevegen receptor, we think that we can remove these immune suppressive elements so that the host immune system gets reactivated again. And if that happens, you actually could have a permanent kind of reaction against the cancer and maybe a even cure. That's what we're aiming at.
And this is for Clevegen, of course?
This is really for Clevegen, yeah.
Right. And the trial itself, that's being conducted across the UK and a site in Finland.
At the moment, we have two sites in Finland, one already running here in London and second soon in Birmingham. And then we have a fifth one in Holland in Erasmus Hospital in Rotterdam. But once we get to the cohort escalation, we will have new additional sites. And you may also have been recognizing that we filed a US IND for the Clevegen. And the aim there is really to open some sites later during this year also there, so that they can actually join the trial during the escalation phase.
And what would that mean, the bigger picture for you?
It will tell us if any of these solid tumor cohorts we are targeting. We have 5 of them, of course colorectal I already mentioned, but we have also liver cancer, ovarian cancer, pancreas cancer and melanoma, all really kind of a non-treatable at the moment. And then we are looking a further clinical efficacy sign, because then we would like to expand those cohorts even further and have a readout maybe after 30 patients or so to see how it's starting to look.
And is this being funded internally by yourselves?
It's funded internally at the moment, and we continue, like we have said, look at possibilities to also collaborate with some interested parties, and of course all those parties are following us as much as anybody else, you know, what kind of data we are producing.
So there has been quite a bit of interest, has there?
I would say that yes, more than I anticipated.
I think, was it correct, am I right in thinking you're hoping to have some sort of partnership deal in place by the end of the year?
Right, that's what we are aiming for. And often you may have a kind of a periods where you need to negotiate and close everything. But if the data gets really exciting and we start to get the efficacy, this is so important area and there are so many companies that we believe that it's doable.
Well, tell me a bit more on that. I know a lot of investors and shareholders are getting quite excited about Clevegen and this study in particular. Why is that? What's the bigger potential
here? Well, if you look at the efficacy levels of the current immuno-oncology products, they could be vary from 10 to 40%, whatever, but the remaining group, like we also indicated last week, who are resistant to current immuno-oncology product, they actually have very high expression of Clever-1 in those tumors, meaning that maybe the Clever-1 somehow is really involved in building up the resistance against the current treatments. So if you would like to improve those or even set up a standalone treatments, you need to have additional ways, and we think that the Clevegen actually could be one of those.
And having a partner on board, would that help as far as potential combination?
Well, especially when you want to expand the trial into a new indications and bigger cohorts and everything, you easily talk significant additional resources needed really to conduct those trials. So for the company like Faron, these are really elementary.
And I suppose with the types of tumors that you're looking at, these types of cancers, these are big markets, unfortunately.
They are untreatable, yeah. So any success with those usually means also success in number of other things. But more important is really to get help to these people.
So when are you expecting, as far as the next couple of months are concerned, what, as far as news flow, what kind of updates are you looking to be providing to the market?
Well, I'm not going to really say directly that, but as this is an open trial we are conducting at the moment, so there is no kind of a final or intermediate readout. You just keep following the patients, and as soon as we have something to announce, we probably will do it, because of course the market wants to know what and how the trial is progressing. Exciting for us as well.
I bet. Markku, good to see you. Thanks for coming in and giving us an update.
Thank you.